Today on Typical Books, we're talking about books. And where I've been, I guess. I've taken a small hiatus, in case you did not notice. But in the meantime, I did do some book shopping at some of my favorite little bookstores. And in particular, where I basically bought everything that I'm going to show off today, aside from what I've already read, is Alice and the Bookman in North Bay, Ontario, because I did go on a little vacation. So yeah, I love this bookstore, and I missed Independent Bookstore Day. I did have a post on Instagram where I talked about some of my favorite bookstores, including Alice and the Bookman and Apport Used Books and Black Squirrel Books, some bookstores around this area. And Allison is one that I like to visit at least annually now, and they have a fantastic horror section which only has been getting better, but I'll get to that in a second. What I've read recently. Did you hear what Eddie Gein done by Harold Schechter and Eric Powell? Fantastic. I may do a little video about all of the graphic novel serial killer books that I have, and I want to get more of them. Believe you me, this is the best way I find to take in with all impact the story of a serial killer, really. There has been some news from a very famous Canadian serial killer who is in hospital right now, Robert Picton. So yeah, it's just true crime on the mind, especially with some of the I've listened to a Maura Murray podcast lately, and I've been listening to and catching up on an Israel Keys podcast. So yeah, I had a lot of fun, as much fun as you can have reading about some of the most horrible, and he is the OG serial killer. So if you're new to true crime, you've not read anything about Ed Gein, I think this is a really good place to start, because it does talk about the crime as it unfolded and a bit of his past. And it's just very tenderly done. And yeah, I really enjoyed Did You Hear What Eddie Gein Done? In the opposite vein, The Haunting of Velkwood by Gwendoline Krist. I love this. We had a short exchange on Facebook, Gwendoline Krist, the author, and I, just about how impactful this was. And yeah, I absolutely recommend this. If you like small town horror, this is really up there. It's not a very typical going back to my hometown and boy does that suck kind of story. She's going back to her hometown and boy does that suck. But the town itself is almost like a Silent Hill type place, and they have investigators surrounding the town, and the investigators themselves almost serve as a character in and of themselves, as a nameless conglomerate Borg that surrounds this town. And I won't give any spoilers other than I loved it so much. And I had just read a story about a town, Withered, that was very similar, but this just blew that concept out of the park, and it is just written so believably, and it just really took me along for the ride. I'm going to have a dedicated review. I have a dedicated review of Withered coming up as well. I've written it, I just haven't recorded it. Apologies if it gets noisy. They are mowing the lawns around where I live, and I just can't seem to avoid it in the summertime. But anyway, Midwestern Gothic by Scott Thomas. I'm halfway through this and absolutely enjoying it. I think I'm absolutely enjoying everything, but I think what happened is I hit a bit of a reading slump before reading these two books, and that is why I've had quite a bit of a delay in recording, because I read a couple books that just didn't really do it for me, so to speak, and put me in a little bit of a So yeah, I'm getting out of it with this. And of course I was on a bit of a vacation, so it's more about buying books at that point than reading the darn things. But yeah, Midwestern Gothic starts out with a bang. If you are interested in the sort of 80s post-Lovecraftian cycle of horror, where people are discovering strange things and there's a lot of stories about cryptic authors and cryptic books, it's a really good story. But it is very modern in that it deals with a very good character building and very strong characters. And yeah, I'm really enjoying this. If you liked Kill Creek, it has mentions of the authors that are in Kill Creek, and a little bit of background on some of them, a little bit of other works that they may have written. And I'm very excited to get to more T.C. Moore, because she is a kick-ass. I'll be doing a proper review of Midwestern Gothic, like I have a review of The Haunting of Velkwood coming up, which was a purchase of my own and something that I just really wanted to read. It was a patron pick as well. So that will be coming up. And Withered, of course, is a little delayed. It came out in April, and the Scott Thomas book came out at the very beginning of May as well. So yeah, I'm a little behind on my reviews, which is why I do not take many. I maybe take about 5 a year. And I'm done them for now, but except for Midwestern Gothic. But yeah, very apologetic in my big delay there, but at least they're all really good reads. Speaking of really good reads, I've got a bit of poetry coming up. This is DL Tillery. You may have seen an unboxing already on Murr's channel over at Harpies in the Trees and other booktubers. I am delayed in this as well. I think that if anything, there is a shame in my reading things that just aren't for me, and it puts everything else in a big delay, like a several weeks delay. So I'm gonna try not do that to myself anymore. I'm gonna read what I'm reading right now, which is very for me. That Scott Thomas book is wonderful. I've got a couple things here and a novella here that will really kickstart it. And I think that this as well will kickstart everything. Thorns of My Heart, DL Tillery, a dark romance poetry collection. I'm not a huge poetry fan or a romance fan, but I'm a huge DL Tillery fan. When she writes poetry, I like it and I read it. Ralph James White has some poetry. Ben Roylance from Apport Books has a little poetry collection, which I'm going to be reading. And this has a little sticker. It's roses in gothy little dead hands. I already love this. And Stay Scared to Lydia Peaver from DL Tillery, and more bookmarks, wonderful stickers, more like otaku kind of goth romance vibes going on. I love bookmarks, so thank you so much. And The Lovers tarot card in black and silver, gorgeous. There are rose petals in the bag, just to give you a little bit of the DL Tillery experience. What a gorgeous bag, what a gorgeous gift, what a gorgeous book, what a gorgeous packaging from a gorgeous writer. So yeah, definitely check out DL Tillery's work. Short stories as well, novellas I've read, really good stuff, a really good booktube channel to follow as well as Instagram. Check out Thorns of My Heart, which launched just recently. And congratulations to Danette on a very successful Kickstarter campaign. This is a book that I found at Allison the Bookman, along with the ones I'm going to talk about here in a second, The Worm and His Kings by Hailey Piper. I was really surprised to see this there. It's an off-limits press book that I kept meaning to pick up. I've heard that it's the best in cosmic horror, best in contemporary cosmic horror, and maybe one of the best cosmic horror novellas stories ever written. So yeah, very excited to get to The Worm and His Kings. New York City, 1990. When you slip through the cracks, no one is there to catch you. Monique learns the hard way after her girlfriend Dana vanishes without a trace. Donna, sorry, I don't have my glasses on. Only after the disappearances of several other impoverished women does Monique hear the rumors. A taloned monster stalks the city's underground and snatches victims in the dark. Donna isn't missing, she is taken. To save the woman she loves, Monique must descend deeper than the known underground into a subterranean world of enigmatic cultists and shadowy creatures. But what she finds looming beyond her wildest fears, a darkness that stretches from the dawn of time across the stars. So it starts out sounding like a creature feature, a typical slasher, some sort of like misadventure drama tragedy that goes succinctly into cosmic horror just in the description alone. So yes, I was very excited to see this there. I don't know how this is going to pick up on camera, but it is a hologram. I love it. Glow in the Dark, number one. Holograms, number two. Wes Craven's Fountain Society. I did not know he did a novel. Now, if you are a fan of maybe Cronenberg's Consumed, where a filmmaker goes and tests the waters in fiction writing, I didn't know Wes Craven had done the same thing. So yes, Fountain Society, a novel. I don't know what it's about. I have no idea. I literally saw the hologram and thought, oh, that's cool. I want that because it looks like altered states. But it's Wes Craven, and it's got a wonderful Wes Craven picture on the back. So yeah, just a really good hardcover of a book I'd never heard of. Have you read Fountain Society. Let me know in the comments if you've read any other filmmakers' dabblings into horror fiction or fiction in general. But Wes Craven, have you read this? This next book is a bit of a mess, but it was a bit of a find. It is the Boris Karloff Horror Anthology. And I had been looking for this. I had tried to snag one off, I believe, Thrift Books, but someone else bought the paperback out from under me. It was maybe like $8 or $9, and it wasn't in the perfect condition. This is not in perfect condition either, by a long shot, but it's hardcover, Souvenir Press. This also included Best South Sea Stories, the Saturday Evening Post Reader of Fantasy and Science Fiction, the Saturday Evening Post Reader of Sea Stories, When Evil Wakes, another anthology, but the Boris Karloff Horror Anthology, just a curated anthology. I don't know exactly how much say Boris Karloff had in this, or if he was, you know, really a driving force as far as editorializing this particular collection, but I guess I will find out. It is just so perfect. So perfect. This is a 1963 Boris Karloff, all rights reserved. It contains Frank Gruber, Edmund Hamilton, Edgar Allan Poe, John Jakes, August Derleth, Evan Hunter, Theodore Sturgeon, C.M. Cornbluth, Robert Silverberg, Roald Dahl, Robert Bloch, and H.P. Lovecraft together at last. So Roald Dahl, I've not read any of his adult fiction before. Each story has a little illustrated frontispiece, cask of Amontillado here. So yeah, I am very excited to dig into the Boris Karloff Horror Anthology. I don't think that's a very good picture. I'm going to take all the wrappings off and take some video here. So you may have seen some of that interspersed already. It was a library book, so it is in terrible condition. And last but not least, this was a real find too, Dead and Buried, Chelsea Quinn Yarbro. I've always said I wanted to read more Chelsea Quinn Yarbro. This is my husband's favorite film, and this is the book, not a novelization. So it was one of those now a major motion picture kind of deals, not a novelization of something existing, but it's got the artwork from the film. So it was released after this particular pressing of it, but it is basically mint. The spine is hardly cracked, if at all. It's perfectly squared, so I don't know if it was ever read, but it does say not read June 83 by whomever had owned it. I don't know if they bought it new and didn't read it ever, or if someone has read it since, because I did get it at a used bookstore. So yeah, it was very inexpensive. It's in very good condition. So yeah, Dead and Buried, a really great film. And I am very excited to see sort of like a Wes Craven and a tangential Wes Craven pick in this as well, because in the film we had Freddy Krueger, a very young Freddy Krueger. So that is a little bit of a shopping haul from Alice and the Bookman to start my summer off. I'm going to be hitting the Mammoth book sale sooner than later, so there will be a few more books to be adding to the collection, and I'll be bringing a few books that I'm unhauling. Maybe a few more will be added to that pile that I showed you last time I did an unhaul. The only time I've really done an unhaul. But suffice it to say, I'm going to be doing a little bit of reading, not so much with the buying, coming up. So there'll be a few more reviews, and Thorns of My Heart will be on the docket to start my summer off right. So thank you so much for watching. If there's anything here in this pile that you've read already, specifically the Wes Craven book, Fountain Society, let me know in the comments below. And have an ooky, spooky day.